Interesting. Okay, so I'm a longtime writer, first time reader, sort of thing. Anybody from Mexico? What part?
The city of Mexico.
The AFA. Well, I don't know, with being Mexican-American and everything, a lot of people can't tell I am because I look like a vampire, kind of. But, yeah, so I got inspired when I was drinking at a gay bar. So this one is the AFA.
Oh,
thank
you. All right.
The city became plagued with political chaos. Some scream we need reform, while others cry for a second revolution. People on the streets are praying for a second coming to save this disastrous economical suffering. There is no such thing as a middle class. The richest men are the ones putting the drugs on the table, and no one can cry change when they're enabled. So that's to my drug addict cousins out there. And Michoacan, anyone? Nobody? Okay, well.
You got one for Juarez?
Yeah, we're just way down south. So, I've been practicing my Spanish. So, anyone speak Spanish? All right, so I'm in good company. Thank you. So, this is La Oración a la Virgen de San Lucas. Querida Virgencita, he viajado por los cerros de Santa Rosalía, buscando la respuesta dentro de una oración. No puedo morir aquí, como una mujer violada, casada, secuestrada y atrapada en un mundo que mide 5 kilómetros. Comiendo tierra, tragando sol, respirando desesperación. Sácame de los cerros de Santa Rosalía, hogar de mi niñez perdida, lejos de Huetamo, cárcel de mujer campesina, llévame lejos de aquí. So, I'm done. Thanks.
Celeste, for sharing that. Do you have anybody else who signed the open mic list, or anybody who hasn't got the open mic list? Who's been here? One last call. All right, if not, we're going to continue with a couple of ZzyZx readers. So I'll start by introducing the president of the ZzyZx writing group. She's the one who's been organizing and hosting most of these things until now. My first time hosting the ZzyZx reading. Kimberly Cobian.
Fearless leader.
Fearless leader.
Thanks, Abram. How's everyone doing?
Good.
Okay, glad. Welcome to our little piece of heaven in the middle of the city. It's really nice. We're really blessed to have this place. We really are. Steve Boland, the owner of Holy Grounds, is out of town, but I think we should just applaud the guy anyway, because he is so awesome. He's really an awesome guy. And then don't forget to tip Gil in there. He's really awesome. He's very efficient. And do you all like your Java and your teas tonight? If you haven't got one, I recommend it. Okay. I'll start with this poem. This is called The Rattly Bulb. You know all the old school bulbs? Though they're becoming old school now, the ones that would that rattle when you know they don't work anymore. So this is like, it's an object, it's an everyday household object, but I use it as like a metaphor for memories.
We're all too young here to know what you're talking about.
I'm old. So the rattly bulb. I forgot to forget again. I kept your love letters where all my future girlfriends could see them. Not on purpose, I swear. I was too busy remembering to fall back on my own shadow to clean the clutter. Your picture is still kissing. My driver's license in my wallet. I don't look 16 anymore. Whoever said it was easier to forget when recalling comes so automatically? She doesn't even try. A natural-born seductress filling the air with her swirls. At least, that's what she reminded me of. Because she never told anybody where she came from. And she looked and thought like she came from 10 different maps. Her curls and curves still foreign to me, even after she guided me. Even with the lights on, I was still in the dark. Which reminds me, I need to replace that bulb in my room. I wrote this one during a poetry writing workshop, during Poetry Palooza, specifically our Downey stop. It was conducted by a very talented poet, Loreen Parks. She told us to write a poem as if we were writing in a postcard to a loved one back home. I have family on my mom's side from El Salvador. So this is to my Tia Santanita out there. Oh, and she gave us three words to work with. Soldier, ant, as in the insect ant, and tortilla. This is how I put them together. Tia Santanita, is the soldier still guarding the rancho? Everything's in English here. Even tortilla sounds flat. My pen chases the period across this card like an ant. I have so much to contarte. Three ants in a row.
Thank you, Kim. Next up, from our ZzyZx family, one of our newest members, actually, and she's done a wonderful job at some local readings that I was telling you before, Poesía para la Gente and La Palabra. We got Karine.